This video is for you if you're setting up your Clever Sync for the first time and you're using the SFTP or manual sync type. In the last video, we walked through setting up your schools.csv file. If you haven't done that already, please review that video first. Now, you'll set up your students.csv file, the second of the 5 required files to set up your Clever Sync. This file has 4 required headers or columns to be uploaded. Keep in mind, you might have some additional required headers depending on the apps you plan to connect with Clever, and you can always add headers as needed. First, you'll start with school_ID, which is the school the student attends. For example, the student in the first row might attend Meadowlark_ELEM. The school_ID must be one of the school_IDs you added to the schools.csv file. If you have a student who attends a school you forgot to include in the schools.csv file, you'll need to go add that school to the schools.csv file. If a student has classes at multiple schools, they should not have separate accounts or be listed twice in the students.csv file. Duplicate accounts will cause login errors. You'll worry about students in classes at multiple schools later in the process. Next, you'll add student_ID, which is a unique identifier for each student. For example, 5177. If your student information system doesn't include this, you can choose any unique value for each student. Student_ID will be used in other files, such as the enrollment file, to tie students to the classes they're enrolled in. Third, you'll add last_name, which is, you guessed it, the student's last name, like Harris. Finally, fill in first_name, like Trevor. After you've added these 4 required headers, the file will be accepted when you go to upload it. That said, we strongly recommend you include student_email, which can make logging in easier when you go to set up a login method for students. There are also other optional headers you can include as needed. Once you're done with that file, make sure you've saved it as a CSV file and add it to a folder for safekeeping. 2 down, 3 to go. Next up, you'll build your teachers.csv file.